my AASR channel. My name is Ilke Wiersma, and today I'd like to show you how I drew this woodpecker. And therefore I use my pastels and my pan pastels. And also my favorite paper, the Claire Fontaine pastel matte paper. I hope I pronounce it right, but I will have a link in this video description below. So I thought it would be nice to show it on the board, and in the outro of this tutorial I will have it framed. But the frame has a glass with which will cause some reflections of my daylight lamps around me. So therefore I thought it would be nice so we can see the image well. And I thought it would be nice to let you see also the image and this artwork framed. So therefore I will show that in the end of the video. But first we'll start with that tutorial. And like I most of the times do, I like to start with the background. I like to work from the furthest away to the front of the artwork. And therefore I lay in the background, and it also helps me to define better my lights and my darks on the main subject. And in this case that will be the woodpecker and also the tree with the moss and mushrooms. But first of all, I will lay in that background, like I said, and therefore I like to use the sponge applicators with the pen pastels. And I had the full set in the these applicators were included with that set, but you can also buy them separately. And therefore I will have a link in my video description, I will have a link in the video description if you are curious which applicators I am talking about. And I really like to use them. And you can also use them for details, but I like to use them for the more bigger parts and to lay in the pastel much easily on the like I said, the bigger parts. But on the details, I really like to use my pencils. And I have two brands of pencils. I like to use the Carbotello pastel pencils and also the Koh-i-Noor. I hope I pronounced them both right. But these brands I like to use, of the pencils of these brands, I like to use for the details. And what you see me do here on the woodpecker. And what I always try to do is to use as many colors as possible. And for example, I like to for this piece, I like to I did use quite some blues and some purples to let it let his feathers shine more, to give it more of a glow onto the bird. And that wasn't that much in the photo, but I like to include it in my artwork to give it him this. Most of the time the animals are a bit more of glow. I really like that look, and therefore I like to use the blues and the purples most of the times. And especially for this part, because there were a lot of blacks, and I like to use the blue on the blacks, and different brown tones. I also like to use the purples, because I do think those fit in quite well. Those colors are very nice together. And I'm slowly building up. I try to copy as much detail as I can, but I'm not copying every little detail. If there are three feathers in one particular spot, I may have two or I may have four. It doesn't matter that much, but I want to have the general feel of the feathers. And I'm slowly building up. That is also very important. Don't rush it. Just try to keep layering and try to keep watch your reference. That's very important. And of course, one of the most important things is to have an accurate drawing. So if you not quite accurate with your drawing, your end piece will of the possibility that is big, that it will not show of end up as nice as you like. So therefore keep take your time to make an accurate drawing of your subject. And in this case it's the woodpecker. So I took the time to lay in of the draw in all those feathers and those little lines, and I like to fill those lines in like I did just a few seconds ago, so I know where to put things. And especially on these wing feathers, there are quite a lot, and those details are quite small, so I like to build up quite slowly, and so I don't lose my lines there. And the white you see here on his in his feathers is most of the time not exactly of pure white, but blues and some yellows, some bit of purple I use, but most of the times different lights and blues, and also some grays. But I'm not using many gray tones, because it can flatten your artwork out quite a bit. So therefore you want like to use more different colors. For example, I like to use blue because it, like I said, it gives more the feeling of a glow. So be aware that if you stick with the browns and the grays, your end piece will not be as nice, in my opinion, as when you use quite some different colors. For example, for this tail feathers, I used at least 4 different blues, but I may end up using 6 or 7 different blues, just depending on how they stand out on a black. And I'm deciding that while I'm working. I also watched my reference quite closely before I start my artwork. I lay out some colors I think I'm gonna use, and I also like to use the picker tool of Pixlr, and I will have a card pop up in my tutorial if you like to know more about it, because I have a tutorial on how I mix my colors quick and easy. And in that tutorial I use my oil paints, but it also works very well with the pastels. With the mixing process is a bit different with pastels than with paint, but yeah, you can use those tools in both scenarios. At least I use them in both scenarios, and I think they might be quite helpful if you have a bit of trouble choosing your right colors. And with the pastels, it's a bit of a different approach when when mixing colors. You want to layer and then blend your colors with one another, and that will give you different colors. So that's the way to mix your colors, and it sounds very easy, but it takes some getting used to. But the more you practice, the easier it will get. And like I said, that color picker tool on Pixlr will help you quite a lot, because you know which direction you should go with your colors. And if you're not sure, I really suggest you try to mix your colors on a separate piece of paper and not directly on your artwork, because if you end up not using the right colors, you can change them easily because you didn't use them in your artwork yet. And when you have found the right mixing of colors, you can apply it in your artwork, so you don't end up having not the ability to cover up the whole piece if you are a little bit off with your colors. And that's how I did it when I started out. And now, most of the times I know which colors I can use and how much influence they will have on the other colors if I lay them on top of them. But if you're starting out, if you have a bit of a problem to getting the right colors, you may want to try it on a separate piece of paper. It helped me quite a lot, that method. So therefore I suggest that. And I'm just building up my details. I'm now working on different mushrooms, and I really like them. I really like this this tree and the mushroom on it, and also that woodpecker on it. It's just a beautiful photo, and I just had to make it because I wanted to have it hanging on my wall, and it's also for sale, but I really like it hanging in my wall. It's just such a nice picture, nice picture of the nature. And I also did like all those details. And when I was halfway this piece, I sometimes think, oh my god, where did I start, because it's quite a big project and it takes a lot of time to finish. But even though with the pastels you are working quite quicker than when you would use color pencils, it would take me a lot of more time then. And I personally don't work with color pencil, it's just not my medium. I don't it doesn't fit me that well, so therefore I like to choose my pastels if I want to use pencils, and also my inktings, of course. But still, it takes some time, and you just want to build up those layers and build up those details. And especially in the beginning, it can seem quite overwhelming if you have a piece this large and with this much detail. But just try to stay cool and work in little sections at a time, and you will get there. And I have to say that most of the times probably with every time I work on a different artwork, I have to say it to myself that it will be fine in the end, because those ugly stages are very hard to go through, but we have to go through them to make really nice, realistic looking art. So you will get used to that, but it's always a bit of a hard time when you are just in the middle of the process, and it doesn't look as you wanted, of course, but you just need more layers and maybe more colors. And especially, most of the times, more darks and more lights.
those will make all the difference. And of course, the colors are important, but the lights and doors, like I probably all the time say, are very, very important. Like on these blue mushrooms, it's very dark. It looks like it's just flat black, but I use different colors there. I don't like to use only my blacks. I normally, most of the times, I use also purples in there. And now you see me layer on some greens just for some details. There's a little bit moss underneath those mushrooms, but you cannot see that moss that well because of it's in shadow. But it is there, so therefore I like to use a little bit of green in this piece over my black to make it just a much richer color, a much richer black. And even though I have sometimes a plastic sheet under my hand, I like to wait for the last section of this artwork until I'm almost finished, because I don't want to have the chance to smudge the pastel over onto the paper where I don't want it. So therefore I did leave that section out just in until the end of this this piece, and it helps like I said to not smudge it as much. And I like to have my hand on the paper, especially layering in details. And my hand is not that steady, so I like to lay it onto the paper. And with a plastic sheet underneath your hand, you are able to come back on areas where you already drawn around. So you will have the chance to smudge it, but with that plastic sheet, you you have the ability to lay in details again, like I do here, or did there. It's quite quickly, but here is the original photo of the artwork. And like I always say, it's a bit different with the colors. This is the most accurate as the original artwork. In my videos, my colors are on my tutorials, my colors are always a bit off. That's because of the daylight lamps, and I keep saying that because it's a little bit frustrating because I cannot see the exact colors I like to use. But I think all the artists who are making tutorials here over on YouTube have the same problem. I didn't have found a artist who had the solution to this problem, but because we need those lights, of course, to see the colors. And in real life, it does look different. But this is the end piece, and I hope you like it, of course.
So, as promised, here is the artwork framed, and I did talk about it before in another tutorial, but I like to collect some frames when I came across them, for example, at my work at a secondhand store, or maybe some garage sales or something like that. If I see a nice frame, I will buy it, and maybe I will use it in a longer time, but I like to store it in my studio, so I have some options there. And for this one, I really liked this piece of artwork with the woodpecker on it, and I thought it would fit this frame quite well. So therefore, I was very glad that I bought this frame, and now it's nicely framed in this beautiful frame. So therefore, I'm happy that I did collect some frames, and I also do that with the frames I use for my paintings as well. So that is maybe a little tip. If you see a frame, you may not know at the moment when you see that frame wherefore you would use it, but of course for some artwork, but you may not have the artwork ready yet. But if you like it, I try to make a piece that will fit in the frame, so therefore I like to have some options. And like I said, I store them here in the studio. So this is how it looks. I hope you can see it quite well with the lamps here and the reflection of the glass. But I hope this gives a nice impression of how it looks framed. And especially the pastel I like to frame because it's easier to store them that way. And to be honest, I don't like to store my work because I'm too proud of it. So I always try to find some place around the house where I can hang it on the wall. And as you can imagine, we have quite some artworks on our walls now. But my husband likes it as well, so I'm very happy of that, because, of course. And because I when I'm finished the artwork, I don't like to store it in a closet or something like that. I really like to show it and to hang it somewhere in our house. So therefore, I like to collect frames so I can frame it right away after I finish the artwork, so it will not get damaged in the process of saving it and store it, this so that it's a little bit easier therefore. And also, if I want to store this, I really would like to frame it, because you can lay the frames on top of each other much easier than when you only would have the artwork. So because you will have to protect it some way, and the frames was already here, so why not use it? And also, like I said, I chose this frame for this artwork because I think it fits very well. But if I don't have frames for a particular artwork, I just use cheap frames, who may not be the best of the most nicest frames, but they are really handy in when you will store your artwork. So that is maybe a little tip there. And for now, I hope you found this tutorial nice and useful. If you like, you can follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and on my own website. And if you like, you can subscribe. I would really like that. And of course, if you like this tutorial, please give it a thumbs up. And for now, I hope to see you at one of my next tutorials. Bye-bye.